What's up guys, I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and today we're checking out an electric scooter that has one secret feature up its sleeve that I've never tested on an electric scooter before. It has dual wheel drive. That's right, it has a hub motor in both the front and the rear wheel. It's very cool. Let's dive in and check it out. Starting with a quick unboxing, this one's called the S5 from CityRover, and it has some sweet features. As always, all the product links will be down in the description. Included is the user manual, a 2-amp battery charger, your two rubber grip handles, and then the main scooter. There's barely any assembly required, which I appreciate. Simply screw in the two handlebars and that's it. Overall design of the S5 is clean and classy, a carbon fiber black design. There's sticker reflectors front and rear, rubber wheels on the hub motors, grip tape on the riding platform, a well-placed underguard plate for protecting the scooter's inner parts. In the back is the other hub motor and a manual wheel brake for those emergency stops. The S5 unfolds and folds down very fast and easy. Again, I like that. Simply pull the lever to release and click into place. There's also a secondary tightening knob to lock it down a bit more securely. I had a little trouble here, more on this one shortly. Scooter weight is about 11.5 kilograms or 25 pounds. Another small but key feature I like is the built-in kickstand. For any electric scooter, I always think these should be mandatory as I use it every time I ride. In the middle front, there's the charging port, and on that note, inside is a 36 volt 10.4 amp hours battery. They say to fully charge takes about 5 hours, and battery life should last you up to 30 to 40 kilometers. That's what they say. That's about 18 to 25 miles. I was not able to test or confirm this. Thankfully, there is a convenient battery life indicator on that backlit LCD screen up top. Power buttons on the front, also a very cool and bright LED headlight. There's this funky horn beeping button on the right and mode changing button on the left. Single tap to cycle through your speeds, 1, 2, or 3. Hold down to switch from front wheel drive only to dual front and rear wheel drive. I really like having the option to turn on and off this feature, as I could see battery life would be extended in single drive mode, but for when you want that extra torque and power, enable dual wheel drive. In the front is a suspension system. This is great for smoothing out the bumps and sidewalks and on the road. However, there's unfortunately no rear suspension on this one. The other key specs inside each wheel is a 36 volt 250 watt hub motor. When dual wheel drive's enabled, you can definitely feel that torque and power difference between this and a single wheel drive system. Climbing hills and steep grade is a breeze. And one side bonus, even though these wheels are pretty small for off-roading, it kind of acts like an ATV, cruising through the grass, dirt, and other terrain without much struggle. I'm impressed with the power and speed these little hub motors can drive me through. So I'll say it again, this dual motor system is genius, and I want to see a lot more scooters implement this dual wheel drive in the future. They say this S5 scooter can carry riders up to 120 kilograms or 264 pounds. As for max speed, they rate it up to 25 kilometers an hour, or that's about 15.5 miles per hour. I ran a couple speed tests with my trusty pocket radar gun, and it clocked me in around 13 miles per hour. However, your mileage and speed may vary depending on rider weight. I was bummed and disappointed with that max speed, and it feels pretty slow. But I learned a secret trick online. You can actually quite easily hack this little scooter and unlock a much faster speed. All I had to do was unscrew the right handlebar, tucked inside is a little blue wire, disconnect it, and man, now this scooter is really fast and way more fun to ride. I clocked in a max speed this time around 19, maybe 20 miles per hour. Now that's sweet. Moving on, the S5 has some nice safety features built in, like the electronic brake isn't alone, though it does stop you quite fast since it's using both motors to electronically brake. But also in the back is that foot brake pedal as a safety backup. Also cool, when you turn on your headlight, which is not only super bright for night riding, there's also a continuous blinking rear tail light on that foot brake. Honestly, this is fantastic to have, and I turn it on day or night. Gives me a little extra peace of mind for safety, giving nearby drivers and pedestrians a heads up of where I'm at. Now, I think this electric scooter could be perfect for college students racing around campus, or the daily commuter or businessman zipping through the city, or maybe nice for running around town, or just for kids and young adults who want a fun and zippy electric scooter. I highly recommend unlocking that extra speed boost and wear a helmet. Now here's just a couple wish list items I have. On my very first ride, I tightened down that secondary screw clamp thing and it stripped right out. They should probably use a stronger metal next time. Thankfully, they sent me a replacement. Also, that LCD screen broke on me as well. The backlight went out, and after 30 minutes of working on it, I was able to swap it out for a replacement unit. Again, they sent me one. Another weird quirk, this scooter gives off this very annoying beeping sound when the battery's low. There's gotta be a way to disable this. Another hiccup I ran into when my buddy Dalton was gently riding on-road into off-road, the front wheel kinda got jacked up. Turns out the bearing sleeve broke. Thankfully, they were very generous and sent me another unit so I could finish my video review. And lastly, I'd love to see a model with larger wheels and a dual wheel suspension system. With dual powerful motors and unlock speed, this would be a ton of fun ripping across all kinds of terrain, jumping off curbs, and ripping through town. If you want to check out the current pricing, as always, all the links down below. Huge thanks to CityRover for sponsoring this video. And if you're new around here, hit that subscribe button for more scooter and tech videos posted every week. Until next time, let's live AuthenTech.